The newest materials for the electronics and optoelectronics industries. Part 1. Intensive work on indium phosphide began in the mid-1980s. At that time, it was needed for electronics for the military. It allowed them to secure very fast electronics, infrared lasers, and detectors. The military had been waiting for that. Under the former economic system, each organization strove to meet its own needs. These materials were not allowed to be imported, so our institute also worked intensively on producing them. That's how things stood until 1990, when everything changed. The political system changed, the Berlin Wall fell, and around the world there was a shift of capital from production for military purposes to consumer goods. Interest in indium phosphide also fell at that time. We were also faced with the problem of whether to continue production of these materials or, like many other centers, slow down or cease production. We concluded that the civilian market for these materials would revive. And so it happened at the turn of the 21st century. An important segment of this market turned out to be preschools, where every child needed a cellular phone. This expanded the market significantly, as did the communications industry, both traditional and wireless. And so, customers from around the world suddenly began asking for this material. Because our technology had achieved a decent level by that time, and the Institute was well known around the world as a representative of Unicor, after some time, they decided that for new materials that were just starting to be developed, it was more convenient to locate the factory close to the research center developing the technology, as opposed to locating it nearer the market, which is the case with more established products. So we signed the appropriate contracts, the plant will be built, and by March, the pilot production line should be operational.
No i podpisaliśmy stosowne porozumienia, zapadła decyzja o budowie fabryki. W tej chwili są uruchamiane pierwsze urządzenia i linia pilotowa powinna w marcu ruszyć.
Każdy z nas miał okazję...
All of us have seen equipment like this with glowing diodes or digital readouts, or has used a telephone or fiber optic cable.
Bądź też rozmawiał przez telefon, przez linię światłowodową.
Semiconductor devices, known as optoelectronic devices, such as lasers, diodes, and detectors, are produced using materials known as A3B5 compounds. We have been producing these types of compounds in Poland for a relatively long time. This includes monocrystals and epitaxial compounds used to produce luminous diodes for watches, digital displays. Unfortunately, at a certain moment, the Polish electronics industry collapsed. Nevertheless, there remained groups who did not accept this fact, particularly those working in research centers. Some work in the semiconductor industry, mainly in the production of semiconductor materials, has continued and has rescued the research and so attempted to keep pace with the industry leaders. We conduct research on methods of producing monocrystals from these compounds. Lately, indium phosphide has been particularly interesting and attractive. It is used in optoelectronic devices, such as lasers, to transmit voice in the form of light waves, which are transformed by the receiver into audible audio waves.
poza detektorem i przetwarzany znowu na sygnał dźwiękowy, który z drugiej strony linii u odbiorcy jest słyszalny, powiedzmy, w postaci dźwięku. Innym
Another attractive use for this material is for high-speed integrated circuits for microwave and optoelectronic devices.
Najwyższej w tej chwili szybkości działania zarówno układy mikrofalowe, jak i optoelektroniczne, w których elementy optoelektroniczne są zintegrowane z elementami mikrofalowymi. Omawiane związki półprzewodnikowe z grupy A3.
Semiconductor A3B5 compounds, which includes indium phosphide, are composed of two elements, one from group 3, in this case indium, and one from group 5, that is phosphorus. The reason these materials are difficult to obtain, as opposed to silicon, is because of their high partial pressure. For example, in the case of gallium phosphide, in phase equilibrium, at the melting point, the partial pressure of phosphorus above the melted indium phosphide is 27 atmospheres. At a melting point of 1,062 degrees centigrade, this creates basic problems in the production of this material. It means it must be obtained under hermetic conditions.
Musi on być otrzymywany w warunkach hermetyzacji. Najprostszym sposobem hermetyzacji
The simplest way is by obtaining it in a vacuum-sealed quartz ampoule into which we introduce a metal ingot of indium with a high purity and red phosphorus, also of high purity, of at least 6N.
Co najmniej 6/9, czyli 1 ppm wszystkich zanieczyszczeń i umieszczamy w odpowiednim pojemniku czerwony fosfor również o wysokiej czystości co najmniej na poziomie 6N. Te materiały nie są w Polsce
These materials are not produced in Poland.
Fosfor
so we obtain phosphorus from Japan and indium, which is a byproduct of zinc production, we presently obtain from the United States, although it is also available in Europe. These materials are placed into the quartz ampoule, brought to the melting point in a vacuum, and when the proper temperatures are reached, which means around the part of the ampoule containing gallium, one higher than the melting point of the compound, and 540 to 560 degrees around the phosphorus, at the coldest end, which ensures an equilibrium point and a phosphor vapor pressure, and particles which unite to form the compound with the melted indium.
Zapewnia nam ciśnienie par fosforu w pobliżu punktu równowagi fazowej, czyli zapewnia nam istnienie fosforu w postaci pary, w postaci cząstek P2 i P4, które wchodząc w kontakt ze stopionym indem powodują powstanie związku. Czyli warunkiem
One condition for the compound to exist in a liquid or synthesized phase is a sufficiently high partial pressure of phosphorus. Another possibility for hermetic sealing and synthesis using this method is by placing indium in a quartz container covered by an appropriate layer of hermetically sealing liquid. In our case, we use boron oxide, which at its melting point, 1100 degrees centigrade, is completely transparent.
Całkowicie przezroczyste, w stanie stopionym w temperaturze topienia związku, czyli około 1100 stopni Celsjusza.
The result of this synthesis in a sealed ampoule are rods of polycrystalline indium phosphide, the charge material in the process of obtaining monocrystals.
Tu jest rezultat syntezy
This is the result of the injection method of synthesis, whereby phosphorus vapor is injected into melted indium under the cover of a layer of boron oxide. This is a very pure polycrystalline material. This method yields large amounts of polycrystalline material, which is further processed to form monocrystals. This is the apparatus used to produce monocrystals of indium phosphide using the Czochralski method, hermetically sealed with a fluid. Here we have the control panel. The actual apparatus is located on the other side of the wall. It is able to work under extreme conditions. The interior consists of the heating unit, on the exterior of which we obtain monocrystals of indium phosphide. The process itself takes place under very high temperatures, over 1,000 degrees centigrade, and at a pressure of around 35 atmospheres. Prior to beginning the process, we program all the parameters into the computer. These are the speed of crystallization, temperature of the heating units. We have a multi-heating system comprising four heating units. We program the profile of crystal we want and the parameters of the process over time. After the crucible is filled, the material is first melted and then crystallized. On the monitor, we can see how the material is crystallizing. Here is the seed crystal. It is dipped into the molten indium phosphide, which is also covered with a layer of boron oxide so the materials don't decompose. Next, the computer guides the crystallization process. Our task is to obtain a monocrystal of a given length, diameter, and with given parameters. The entire process is controlled by computer, but we cannot program the actual structure.
My nie możemy na przykład zaprogramować sobie tutaj struktury. Wiemy, że myśmy założyli.
Here we've installed a seed crystal with given parameters. But during the process, twins may form, in other words, a double crystal. If so, then we need to correct the parameters and start the process all over again. The result of this process is a crystal with a diameter of 2 inches and a length of over 20 centimeters. The longest crystal was 28 centimeters long, which is a world record.
To jest, można powiedzieć, że to jest osiągnięcie światowe.